What's going on YouTube? It's Darian from the Honey Road. Today I want to talk about 5 ways to know that entrepreneurship is for you. So I know that sounds a little counterintuitive. The characteristics of an entrepreneur should be pretty self-explanatory, but the funny thing is that it's not. So I hope that by sharing these things, if you watch this video, or if you've been thinking about entrepreneurship or going into business for yourself and you've been kind of on the line, hopefully if you hear these 5 things and you can kind of relate them to yourself and kind of say, yeah, I have those traits, then maybe it'll help you really break the threshold and cross that line and really become an entrepreneur for yourself. Entrepreneurship in itself is all pretty much revolves around the same thing. So I want to share these 5 things with you. And if you can really identify with maybe 3 or more of these things, then entrepreneurship is definitely something you should probably take a look into. So 5 ways to know entrepreneurship is for you. Number 1, you're responsible. So you actually prefer to have most of the tasks or most of the responsibility on your plate. And it's funny because lots of people aren't that way. A lot of people would actually rather be told what to do than to take the responsibility on themselves of watching over other people or managing other people and making sure everything is done. So if you're that person that normally takes charge and you want that responsibility, then entrepreneurship is definitely something you might see yourself thriving in. It's very important too, because as an entrepreneur, there's no one there to really make decisions for you. If you have your own business or your own company, every single decision, big or small, pretty much is on your shoulders. So you have to be okay with not having somebody to go to, not having a cavalry show up behind you to come save you if you make a mistake. You have to be okay with taking on responsibility when things go well and your company is doing successful and doing really good. And you also have to be willing to take the responsibility when your company goes down the drain, if ever, God forbid, but if your company goes south, you also have to be ready and willing to take responsibility for the mistakes that happened or whatever went wrong. The second way to know that entrepreneurship might possibly be for you is that you hate repetition. If you hate repetition at your job and you hate going and doing the same thing over and 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 over, then you know entrepreneurship is definitely something you might want to take a look at, because every day is different. You have no idea what could be thrown at you on any given day. Things could go very well one day, things could go very bad one day. You might not have anything to do one day and you might be able to enjoy your time and make money while you're just not doing anything really work related. Or you could have a full day where you don't have time for anything because you're so overwhelmed with work and there's just so much needs to get done because you're working on a deadline and you're working towards a goal that needs to be met in a certain time frame, or you're working within a team, you know, with your employees or something like that. So if you hate repetition, you know, that is a really, really, really big sign, because I used to work at Starbucks. So, you know, I hated like brewing coffee every day and making the same Americanos every day and Frappuccinos and Cappuccinos, like the same process of going into work, smelling the coffee, grinding the coffee, brewing the coffee, serving the customers, checking the register, being on bar and making drinks and working the drive-thru. Like, that is not cool. Going into work, knowing what to expect every day, knowing what you're gonna get paid, knowing what you're gonna make every 2 weeks is not always like the best feeling in the world. So if you can relate to that, and if you felt that way, if you've experienced those types of feelings, that could be your inner entrepreneur trying to come out. So don't be so quick to say that entrepreneurship isn't something for you because you've never thought about it or explored it, because I mean, you may really just need to find what you're passionate about and find a way to monetize that and turn it into something that you love, but also something that creates revenue for yourself and for other people, that creates jobs, that creates wealth in your community. You don't have to look at business and entrepreneurship as being selfish or money hungry or greedy. You can definitely do it because it's something that you're passionate about. You want to solve a problem that you don't see being solved right now, or you feel you can innovate something and make it better than what it already is. So it doesn't always have to be about money or about greed. So, you know, don't worry if you feel that's not the reason you're not a business person or entrepreneurship isn't for you. You know, don't be quick to write it off, okay? Number 3, you feel your way is better. So a lot of times, this is the way I used to feel. If someone gives you a task or tells you to do something, so say your boss, your supervisor, you know, asks you to do something and it's stupid. It's a dumb task. They say mop the floor, or, you know, just something really minuscule. and you want to know like why, or you know, why are we doing this that way? Or if something's done like a really traditional old fashioned way and you just know there's a better way to do it, or there's an easier way to do it, there's a more convenient way to do it, or you know you can just come up with something better than what's being implemented at the moment. If you're always thinking that every time someone, you know, comes up with an idea, or you know, your superiors think that they know what's best, but you know for a fact that you have a better plan, and that's really just how you generally think, then entrepreneurship is definitely an arena that you might want to compete in. Feeling that your way is better is really what evokes the enthusiasm and the passion to be able to take rejection. And there's lots and lots and lots of rejection in business. So having that tough skin and that very high confidence that my way is better, or I know I could do better, that's very important. A lot of people mistake that in business people as arrogance and egotistical, but in all actuality, they've been through a lot in business and they've faced a lot of rejection and they've had really great ideas that have been shut down by people who thought they knew better. So before you jump to say that, you know, saying that my way is better or feeling that my way is better is arrogant or is cocky or anything, not really, because you could be a very innovative person. Your way could be better, but if you never share it, if you never voice that opinion, how will anyone know how innovative you are? How will anyone know how creative you are? How will you know how innovative you are? How will you know how creative you are? You know what I mean? So feeling that your way is better is actually a very, very important characteristic for any entrepreneur, anyone who's thinking about going into entrepreneurship. Number four, you'd rather be in charge. So again, this kind of ties in with you're responsible, but if you'd rather be in charge in most scenarios that involve other people and groups, then that's a very heavy clue, a very big hint that entrepreneurship is maybe for you. Again, lots of people don't like being in charge. Lots of people don't like the responsibility of something's success or failure depending on them. The thing about entrepreneur is, generally speaking, they don't see failure, or they don't realize failure to be an option. And that enthusiasm, that resilience, that perseverance, that is really what makes successful business people. If you feel that your way is better often, you're responsible, you hate repetition, and you also would rather be in charge, I mean, I think those four things right there, even if you can identify with 3 out of 5, you're definitely on the right track if you're considering being an entrepreneur. Number 5, you recognize the skills of others. Now, this one is probably the most specific and probably one of the more unique characteristics that I think that are very important to being an entrepreneur, is you have to be able to see other people's talent, and you have to be able to assess other people's skills too, because you never know who could become an asset to you or your business. And if you're going out to networking events, or if you're just out and you're just doing something in the community, you're at the mall or whatever, being an entrepreneur, work never really stops. Business never really stops, because you could be talking to someone who could become a very influential person in your business or to you as a mentor, or they could have other connections. So you just never know. You can never really turn the business side of you off. Even if you do have lots of skills, you're only one person, and delegating tasks is just as important as you being sound as an entrepreneur and as the leader of the group. Your ability to give tasks to the right people who are best fit for that job based on their skills and their traits and what they're good at, you have to know who can exceed my expectations, do it better than I can, and get the job done. Who's responsible enough to get this done the way I would like it to be done? And be able to assess their abilities and their character too, so that you can really leverage those people and get the most out of them to have your business be successful, and to have the morale and the overall confidence and happiness of your team, because you want a strong unit with everybody that you're working with, because you're all working towards the same goal. You're all working towards the same mission. So it's very, very, very important that you guys have a great relationship, a great rapport, and that everything is well understood across the board. So those are the 5 ways to know if entrepreneurship is for you. I'll be doing more videos pretty soon coming up. Go back and check everything else out on the Behind Your Road if you guys haven't already. And check out my books too if you guys haven't. Be a Father to Your Child and the Happiness Formula, Escaping the Self-Trap, over on Amazon.com. And also be sure to check out the hiking videos on Behind Your Road. Share them, you know, if you know anybody that hikes. You know, go check those out. And I'll be sure to see you guys in the next video, all right?